Share them all with you. Maybe by next summer we won't have changed our tune. We'll still want to be with the butterflies and bees, making up new numbers and living so merrily. I'll share them all with you. I'll be here for you always, and always be with you. Come along with me, and the butterflies and bees. We can wander through the forest and do so as we please, living so
good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Church of Silver Spring. I'm Nora Strauss-Riggs, and my pronouns are she, her, hers. This month, our theme for worship is Beloved Community. This morning, we lean together into the mystery, welcoming that which we can't control and which is beyond our imagination, to lead us into a future full of possibility. I'm glad all of us are here together, taking advantage of the ways we can connect across distance and difference in community. Whether you are joining us live or watching this service after the live broadcast, I'm so glad you're here. I'd also like to welcome anyone who is joining us for the first or second time. Pat Hulsbusch is our welcoming captain and would be glad to answer your questions in the chat. Pat will also be available during virtual coffee hour after the service. If you are watching live, you can log into Google to participate in the chat in real time. To help protect privacy, comments will not be available for later playback, but during the service, they are very public, so please keep that in mind. Also, please note that the live chat has certain safety features to prevent disruptive comments, so you won't be able to post, special characters or complete web addresses. American Sign Language Interpretation is available in a separate Zoom room for those who are deaf or hard of hearing. If you need help finding that link, please ask in the chat or email vstechsupport@uucss.org to get the link. In a few minutes, everyone will be invited to light our flaming chalices. So now is a good time to go and get a chalice, candle, or even a flashlight, so you can join in kindling the flame of community. But first, let's take a moment to say thank you to all those who have made today's service possible.
Now please join us for the chalice lighting and congregational commitment. May this light warm our hearts with love and caring and guide us in the ways of truth. As we gather here for worship, we pledge ourselves to the endless search for truth, to the right of each to believe as mind, heart, and conscience dictate, to accept the responsibilities this freedom commands, and to implement our belief in the essential worth and dignity of every human being.
Thank you.
This is the poem I Won't Hatch by Shel Silverstein. Oh, I am a chickie who lives in an egg, but I will not hatch, I will not hatch. The hens, they all cackle, the roosters all beg, but I will not hatch, I will not hatch. For I hear all the talk of pollution and war, as the people all shout and the airplanes roar. So I'm staying in here where it's safe and warm, and I will not hatch.
Come old Fat Top, he come grooving up slowly. He got juju eyeball, he won holy roller. He got hair down to his knee. Got to be a joker, he just do what he please. Wear no shoe shine, he got toe jam football, he got monkey finger, he shoot Coca-Cola, he say, I know you, you know me. One thing I can tell you is you got to be free, come together right now over me. He peg production, he got walrus gumboot, he got oh no sideboard, he won spinal cracker, he got feet down below his knee. Hold you in his armchair, you can feel his disease. Come together right now over me. He roller coaster, he got early warning, he got muddy water, he won mojo filter, he say one and one and one is three. Got to be good looking, cause he's so hard to see. Come together right now over me.
You belong here. The stars belong in the deep night sky, and the moon belongs there too, and the winds belong in each place they blow by, and I belong here with you. The whales and the fishes belong in the sea, and to the waves belong by the shore, and the dunes where the grasses belong to be, because grasses are what dunes are for. And the trees belong in the wild woods, and the deer belong in their shade, and the birds belong so safe and good and warm in the nest that they've made. And you belong where you love to be, and after each day is through, you will always belong right next to me, and I'll be along next to you. The frogs and the lilies belong in the lake, where the water is silver and clear, and the turtles belong in the homes that they make, in the sand where the water is near. And the otters belong by the banks of the stream, and the cattails belong there too. And the carp belong where the water runs green, and the shadows all run blue. And you belong right here, where you're home, and where I hold you close. Of all the wonders I've ever known, you're the one I love the most. The hares belong in the desert air, where the rocks are red and gold. And those rocks belong with the comets out there, which flash bright when the night turns cold. The foxes belong in the high canyon hills, and the sage there belongs in the sun. And the lizards belong in the light sitting still until it is time to run. The crickets belong in the old stone wall, and the bees belong in the clover, just as winter belongs in its place after fall, before the new year starts over. And you are a dream that the world once dreamt, and now you are a part of its song. That's why you are here, in the place where you're meant, for this is right where you belong. The pines belong on the mountainside, tucked under their blankets of snow. And for the bears, belong in the caves where they hide whenever the storm starts to blow. Some creatures were made for the land or the air, and others were made for the sea. Each creature is perfectly home right there in the place it belongs to be. And no matter what places you travel to, what wonders you choose to see, I will always belong right here with you, and you'll always belong with me. The end.
Hi, my name is Danielle Levesque, and I use she/her pronouns. Now is the time for sharing of joys and sorrows. In this congregation, we take time each week to share the most important pieces of our lives with one another. Each and every Sunday, we have the opportunity to learn of the greatest joys and sorrows in other people's lives, and to share our own. And we do this because bearing witness to one another's lives is a sacred act. If you are worshiping with us live, I invite you to type your joys or sorrows into the chat box during the music provided by our lovely and talented Nora Strauss Riggs. Everything shared in the chat box is public during the live stream, so please keep that in mind as you decide what to share. If you need additional support, please send an email to layministers@uucss.org and they will be in touch. But you don't have to be a lay minister to reach out to someone whose joy or sorrow touches your heart. So please make note of those people who you may wish to call or send a card, text, or email to this week. And if you are watching this as a recording later, I invite you to take this time to hold your joys and sorrows in your heart and to lift up in prayer and loving regard all those who are in need. Let us now open our hearts to the joys and sorrows this gathered community has to share.
lunchtime, I bought a huge orange. The size of it made us all laugh. I peeled it and shared it with Robert and Dave. They got quarters and I had a half. And this orange, it made me so happy, as ordinary things often do. Just lately, the shopping, a walk in the park. This is peace and contentment is new. The rest of the day was quite easy. I did all the jobs on my list. I enjoyed them and had some time over. I love you. I'm glad I exist.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride if I have things you need to borrow for.
These times of social distancing and social divisions have taken their toll. Bodies need embracing and humans need belonging, proximal contact of our very being. Hearts are lonely, the mind stressed, souls restless in the malaise, foreshadowing the earth out of balance and communities under attack. Cleaning up our mess with hands, getting dirty from the hard work of change and peace. Turning our attention to and being present in the human heart's absolute good of the new way. persevering these old trials in, with, and through the radical grace and radical love from which we actively resist separation. O my soul, let me see through you. Now all things shine with the light of truth, beauty, and goodness. Here we stand.
I am a high school student. I have friends in a lot of different circles, and up until last March, I saw my school friends basically every day. Once the pandemic started, I had to find other ways to stay in touch. I've seen a couple of people in person, but it's all been socially distanced and with masks, and that just isn't the same. I've been texting with a whole bunch of people, and I'm on the phone fairly regularly with a couple. Now, obviously you can't hang out like you used to. Masks and social distancing simply makes that impossible, but anything else would just be unsafe, and we can't have that. That said, I have seen a few friends since March. We've walked around and gotten coffee a few times, and while it is nice, like I said, it's not the same. There are no hugs, no sitting next to each other, and certainly no going inside. Especially rough during these winter months where it's, you know, cold. I am extremely grateful that I'm able to see my friends, even in such a limited way, during this time. And to be honest, I'm not sure what I would have done without them. There is another way to keep in touch, without actually seeing anyone in person. This is, of course, calling and or texting. This has been the main way that I've stayed in touch with friends throughout everything, and I mostly use Instagram to text for a couple reasons. It feels weird to ask for phone numbers somehow, but also Instagram has pretty colors, and I like pretty colors, so. Texting, it's not the same as being in person. It's not even really the same as calling. At least with calling, you get tone. With texting, you don't get body language, you don't get tone, you don't get any of the countless subconscious ways that we inform how we communicate to people. But it's better than nothing, and I've done it quite a bit more than calling over quarantine, for the simple reason that not all my friends are comfortable calling. This could be for, you know, anxiety, or data plans, or whatever other reason. The ones who do like to call, I will call and we will be on the phone for hours. It's real fun. It is a blast. I am also extremely active on social media. I have Twitter and, as I previously mentioned, I have Instagram. A couple Discord servers that I'm quite active into. These communities, especially a certain subsection of Twitter known as GST, Graham Sister Twitter, don't ask, and the WBNE Discord server, which is a podcast network that I support on a crowdfunding website called Patreon, and get access to their Discord server because of that. These two communities have been invaluable to my mental health over the last 11 months. The last thing I've done is something I've only done a few times, but it's surprisingly fun whenever I have done it. This is watch parties. Whether over Zoom or just over Netflix, these are real fun. I've watched John Mulaney specials, all of them, and Back to the Future and a couple other things with friends or groups of family over the months. It's a lot of time investment and takes a little bit more planning to set up than some of these other ways, but honestly, it's well worth it. In short, I've used a variety of methods to stay in touch with friends in these unprecedented times. These include texting, calling, social media, and the occasional walk. It's been a difficult year, for sure, but my friends have been one of the main things keeping me sane through it. Thank you.
Our time in quarantine has been difficult. Every day here seems to be more news drama and just a lot of stress from everything. That's not what I'm going to be talking about today. Instead, I'm going to focus on some positive things that have happened because of the shutdown. Now you might be thinking, but Ella, how could anything good come out of a worldwide pandemic? I'll tell you, it's the little things. That saying has probably been repeated to you so many times that it just goes over your head, but just stay with me for a bit. Most of the time, whenever huge positive events happen in the midst of a large negative mess, it can feel incredible. But when you have to face the negative event again, it throws everything out of whack. That's why I've chosen to look at the little things. Here are some examples of small things that brought a little light into this world of darkness. Number 1. My bed. I mostly likely sound like a lazy teenager right now. My bed is so comfortable. I have a memory foam mattress with a memory foam pad on top of it. Basically, every time you lay in it, it feels like you're getting a hug. I also have the perfect pillows. They support my neck correctly, whether I'm laying on my side, back, or stomach. There's also the blankets. Since it's winter, I have my large comforter on my bed, but for the rest of the year, I have a fuzzy green blanket. Of course, I still have it on in the winter, too. And then, there's the best part. The stuffed animals. It sounds childish, but having stuffed animals makes the sleeping experience 10 times better. Especially if you have a large one. I personally have an IKEA elephant and an IKEA shark. Combined, they fill up about half of the bed, but I don't mind. My iPad. There's a little bit of a story time about how I got it before I get into why I made this list. Earlier in the school year, there was a teacher I didn't really like. There was something about him that just kind of rubbed me the wrong way. My parents saw that I didn't like the teacher and remembered that I had been asking for an iPad for years, and told me that if I passed the class, I could get an iPad for Christmas. Obviously, I still failed the class. Just kidding. I turned in all my missing assignments, got a B on the last group project, and scored 100% on my final test. So under the tree on Christmas Day, the first thing I opened is my new iPad. So that's how I got it, but why did it make this list? There are a lot of nice things about having a larger screen. I can watch sad shows with great screen quality and appreciate the visuals as tears stream down my face. It's also good for drawing, and I've almost completely switched to digital art, though I'm still not that good at all the controls and stuff. I can use it for online classes if I'm running late or if I lost my school Chromebook. It's also great for texting. The large keys make typos almost never happen. Okay, I'm done with a sales pitch for you to get an iPad. On to the next thing. Friends and family. I'm going to be a little bit cheesy here, but having support from loved ones is always a pick-me-up. I love waking up in the morning to see that people texted me. It makes this isolation a lot less lonely. I put this on this list not because it's a little thing, but because I think it's always important to talk about. Thank you for listening to me to talk for about 3.5 minutes. I hope you took something out of this, or at least enjoyed this story.
I think it is safe to say that 2020 was a year that was strange for all of us. Between the global pandemic, wildfires, and violence in this country, everyone has had challenges that they had to overcome. I remember the start of quarantine, when it was announced that we would be doing online school for a couple of weeks until the school system found a safe way for us to get back into the classrooms. It has been 10 months since then, and I haven't seen the inside of a classroom since. Learning how to deal with online learning has been difficult for everyone, both students and teachers. The virus that has ravaged the world has claimed the lives of 433,000 Americans and 2.19 million worldwide. Yet somehow this hasn't really sunk in for me. I still wake up in the morning and instead of thinking about all those who we have lost, I think about the hours of homework I have to get done, or what after-school activities I have to do. I think that the reason the gravity of my situation isn't hitting me is because there is simply too much to take in. There have been too many memorable events in 2020 for me to be able to process them all. Even now, as I write my reflection, I have trouble condensing all of my ideas into something that is even remotely coherent. 2020 has revealed something about me that I never knew existed. It showed me how I cope with tragedy upon tragedy. It showed me that when my senses get overloaded, when there are too many events to process, I shut it all out, and I focus on my daily life. I feel like this is some sort of survival reflex. And the more I think about it, the more it starts to make sense. I think my reflex to block out events, to keep going, is similar to the fight, flight, or freeze reflex. When we go through the fight, flight, or freeze reflex, we are doing it to survive. Generally, that reflex keeps people alive when they are in danger, and it allows them to get out of a dangerous situation. I feel like to a lesser extent, the same is true with my filtering reflex. If I were to think about all the tragedies that happened last year, all day, every day, I would never get anything done. I would shut down. I would freeze. So instead, I chose the flight option, and choose to decide to ignore it, to block it all out. And I think that most people are experiencing a similar thing right now. I think that many of us are united by this feeling. Whenever I do Zooms with family or friends, we don't talk about the COVID cases. We don't talk about how many are gone. We talk about much more trivial things, like school and work. This is evidence for me that the human race has an incredible ability to move on. We are united by the fact that after tragedy, we still somehow find a way to move on. So I think that 2020 was a pretty much one big test. And I think that we are in the final few questions right now. And judging by how we're doing with this test, I think it's pretty safe to say that we will pass. Thank you.
I now invite each and every person tuning into the service, whether live or at a later time, to make a financial offering to this congregation. Your offering today will help fuel the flame of this community and make our ministries and programs possible. But most importantly, making an offering will allow you to practice generosity, to contribute to a community that can do more good together than any of us can do alone. There are three ways you can make your financial gift to the congregation. The first is by downloading the Give Plus mobile app from Vinco to set up an account. The second way to give is by using your phone to text a message to 833-880-1363. And if the app or texting just doesn't work for you, the third way to give is by mailing a check directly to the church. All of the information you need for all three of these methods is on your screen now and will appear again towards the end of today's service. Every program, our different ministries, and all of the support and music and fellowship of this congregation is possible not because we charge people to participate, not because we attach a fee to all that we do. It is possible through the shared generosity. I hope you will join me in making an offering in thanks to all that UUCSS means to you. The offering will now be given and received with gratitude.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again, when I see you again.
Damn. All the planes we flew, good things we've been through, that I'd be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you would stand in there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you.
again.
We've come a long way.
We came a long way.
From where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
You both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong, and what's small turn to a friendship turn to a bond, and that bond will never be broken, that love will never get lost. And when brotherhood comes first and that line will never be crossed, established it on our own when that line had to be drawn, and that line is what we treat, so remember me when I'm gone. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you're gonna be with me for the last ride.
Let the light guide your way. Hold every memory as we go. And every road you take will always lead you home. It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
May the gifts we've given fuel the flame of our commitment. Empower us to serve our mission and give the life we share the shape of truth, love, and justice.
Good morning. Good morning and welcome. I'm your leader, Peyton Bradley Ryder, a member of the YRUU, aka the Cool Kids Club. And I'm here with your church announcements. Your annual budget drive co-chairs, Margot Kelly and Tessa Marks and Jamie Jorgensen, are busy preparing for the 2021 ABD campaign, aka the annual budget drive campaign. Rolling up our sleeves, the campaign launches publicly on March 21st. Before then, they're looking for volunteers for visiting stewards. If you're interested in volunteering or have any questions, send an email to abd@uucss.org. That is abd@uucss.org. And mark the calendar for one of two trainings on March 7th at 3 p.m. and March 18th at 7 p.m. That is March 7th at 3 p.m. or March 18th at 7 p.m. Thank you, and you're welcome.
Every prophet sought out companions. A wall standing alone is useless, but put three or four walls together, and they'll support a roof and keep the grain dry and safe.
When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from a nice warm bed, you just remember what your old pal said, for you've got a friend in me.
that you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. You got trouble, I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We'll stick together and see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. Some of the folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, bigger and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. Just me and you, boy. And as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend.